Welcome to today's fantastic tutorial. Today we are going to learn about the new select and mask feature in Adobe Photoshop CC 2017.1 latest update. And they have added certain new features to the select and mask option in Photoshop. So we are going to learn all of that today. All right. And before I go any further, I would like to tell you that this is a part of my full course, which is called the Master Photo Manipulation in Photoshop with the Sci-Fi Warrior Photo Manipulation for Beginners. This is a project-based course where you can learn the photo manipulation by creating the project, which is the Sci-Fi Warrior in this course. And this course has lots of content, and it has around 1 hour plus full HD lectures. You can learn each and everything regarding the photo manipulation in this course. This course comes with 30 days full money back guarantees, and so you have a zero risk trying this course. As within 30 days, if somehow you don't like this course, you can claim your 100% money back. And you can see this class curriculum. We have all these options, and you have the option to download the exercise files as well, so that you can follow along and learn even further. So the full price of this course, regular price of this course, is $195. But if you join right now with the link in the description section, then you can get this course just for $27. All right. So if you are interested, go ahead, purchase it. Otherwise, enjoy the free tutorial. So let's get started. Welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we are going to learn about the new select and mask option in Adobe Photoshop CC 2017.1 release. So this is, let me just show you the Photoshop version. This is Photoshop 2017.1 release. Okay. And this is the latest release. And in this release, they have added a new option to select and mask option in the Photoshop. All right. And I'm going to show you how we can make the selection with the help of this new option. Okay. So moment, as you can see, I select the quick selection tool or magic wand tool right over here. Let me just show you. Here we have the option of select and mask even before we make any selection. Okay. So if I just click over here, select and mask, it is going to open up this window. Okay. And here on this window, you can see right now we have a quick selection tool, and we have refined as brush tool, which was earlier there. Now we have the brush tool here as well. We have the lasso tool as well. And if we'll click our mouse, we have the polygon lasso tool and hand tool and zoom tool. Okay. And here we have the option to choose select or sample or layers. Okay. So we can check or uncheck that as well. And over here, this is all the same which was earlier, but they have added a new feature which is of transparency. Okay. Let me just show you how transparency works. As you can see, at the moment you might be seeing the transparent background, and if I increase it to 100%, you see only the transparent background. So you can see the transparency, and you can adjust this transparency of the image using this slider. Okay. And all these options are the same which were earlier there. Okay. And over here from this drop down menu, we have the option to select on skin. This is onion skin option, I think, which was not available earlier, and now it is available over here. Okay. And now, since we have not made any selection to this image, we have directly come into the refine mask and refine as option. Now, how we can create the mask on this, or how we can create a selection. Okay. So here we have the option to choose this quick selection tool, which is over here. You can press W on your keyboard as well. And now we can start painting on the image. And you can see it is going to create a selection for us, and it is very quick, and it understands that which area we want. Okay, and this works very, very fine compared to the earlier tool. So you can keep on painting and it is going to create a selection for us. All right, and we can paint over here and over here and on her dress and on her hairs. Okay, and it is going to make a selection of all the areas based on our pixels where we paint. Okay, and if I just decrease the size of this quick selection tool by pressing left bracket or open bracket, or if I, or I can increase the size by right bracket or the close bracket. Okay, and I can paint over here, and it is going to make the selection of this as well. And how you see now whether the selection has been made or not, you can increase this transparency to 100%. And right here you can see what selection has been created with the help of this quick selection tool. Okay, so you don't have to go down and select on layers or on white or other options. If you want to see your result on the transparent background, you can right now do this with this transparency sliders. Okay, and now as you can see, some of the areas are left out, so I'm gonna paint with the brush tool on those areas as well, on some strands of hairs here as well. And I don't want to this flower to come into picture, or let it be over here. And some dresses, some of her dress is left out, so I can paint over here as well. All right, let some flowers come, that's not a problem for me, because my purpose is to make the selection of the hairs. Okay, so I can create a cutout. And here we have the option of, again, of which was earlier there as well, smart radius. And if I uncheck it and check it, and then I have the option to adjust this radius. So I'm basically telling the Photoshop to go a little bit further from the selection and make out the edges. Okay, and I can keep on increasing it until it gets selection of the hairs. And then now you can see, this was before, it has not selected the thin edges of the hairs, and moment I increase it, it's going to make the selection of those edges as well. Okay, and let me increase it a little bit further, and I think now the hairs are selected properly. And now here comes the refine edge tool. As you can see, some of the yellow colors has been selected between the hairs, which we don't want obviously. So we'll come over here and we'll select this refine as brush tool. Okay, and we'll select it. And now what we need to do, we need to first paint on the area which we want to keep, and then we'll paint on this yellow color. So I'll paint here and then on this yellow color, and it's going to take time, and it is going to remove that yellow color. Okay, and you can see right now, and let me just do it once again. And doing this, I can remove all the yellow colors or the unnecessary background which I don't want in the selection or the final outcome using this technique. And if I want, I can increase the size of this refine as brush tool as well by open bracket or left right bracket. And it takes a little bit time because this selection process is little heavy. Okay, and it depends on how much free RAM you have on your system, because you might have noticed sometimes when your RAM is totally full, then you are not able to make the selection, and Photoshop gives you the error message that cannot make the selection since RAM is full. So make sure you free up your RAM on your system. You close all the background running apps or other softwares if you are using them, because Photoshop is really, really heavy thing, okay? And it needs lots of free RAM to work on that or to work properly, okay? And you can see that moment I am doing it, it is going to create the perfect selection for us. It is going to refine it, and this process takes time. You have to keep on doing until you are happy with the result, all right? But the end result would be worth the time which we are putting in creating this selection, because selecting hairs is really a tough task. But with this new tool, new options, it has become hell easy, man. Hell easy. Yes. And my system might be very slow for the moment because I'm just also recording in full HD so that you people can learn, okay? And that's why my system or my Photoshop is taking that much of time to refine the edges. Otherwise, it doesn't take that much of time, okay? And let me do a little bit over here as well. And you can refine little bit from here and over here as well. And basically, my purpose is to tell you how you can use this new feature and how you can make the toughest selection very easily in Photoshop. So I can even work a little bit more on this, but I'm just showing you the result. All right, let me just show you the result. And it is completed. And if I increase the transparency to 100%, now we can see that we have made a good selection, okay? And here we have all the other options like smoothing. So if you want the edges to be a little smooth, because if you have the very sharp edges, that doesn't look good. I normally increase the smoothing to 20 to 30%, all right? And you have the feather option. You can feather whether you want the edges to be that hard or have little bit feather so that it gets mixed with other background if you are going to change the background. And here we have the option to contrast, to control the contrast of these edges. This contrast option affects the edges of these hairs, so small edges. So make sure you don't go that much, because that would make the selection very ugly. All right, so you have a little bit contrast, that's fine. And here we have the option to shift edges, whether you want these selection which we have just created to shift either inside or outside. So you can do that as well if you want, but here we don't need that. And then over here we have the option to decontaminate colors. So if there are certain colors, you can see that if there is some yellow which is spilling over to the hairs or on the skin or on the clothing, then it is going to take care of that. And you can see the difference by turning it on and off, how this one looks good, okay? And here we have the option to choose whether we want it to be a selection layer mask or new layer with layer mask. But I would suggest that you always go for new layer with layer mask. That way your original layer would be available for you and you don't have to be worried about making any changes, all right? And you can press okay. And now you can see we have successfully created the selection of the hairs using the new features select and mask in Adobe Photoshop 2017.1 update. So thank you so much. I hope you have understood, and if you have any question, you can leave that in the comment section below. So thank you so much. Bye bye. So thank you so much. I hope you have learned something very useful from today's episode. And if you like today's episode, please don't forget to hit the like button and please do subscribe to my channel for more videos. Subscribing is absolutely free. All you have to do, you just need to click that big red button below this video and you would be subscribed to this channel. So whenever I will be uploading a new video, you would be notified about that video and you will not miss any new learning. Again, if you are interested in my 1 hour plus course, Master Photo Manipulation in Photoshop, then you can check out the link in the description section below. And the regular price for this course is $195, but you can get this just for $27 if you are interested, which is, I think, more than 92% off. All right. So thank you so much. Bye bye. See you in the next episode.